you. Be careful.
I'm gonna try.
Be careful.
That's it. You're going for it.
Hey guys, welcome to another video. We're gonna do something different in this one. I'm gonna do a little narration and explain what's going on in this race and see how you guys like it. And if you like it, leave a comment below. Alright, so we take the green flag on this championship weekend, the last race of the year. And this race is gonna decide who wins. It's down to me and Gerardo and he needs to win the race. He has to win this race. If he finishes anywhere but first place, he is out and I am in. And that's what I want. So he's actually starting behind me. We didn't start in the front row for this one. A little bit better qualifying times or race times out of the other drivers. One of the things that SCCA is doing this year, at least in the New England region, is starting grid is lined up by your best time from any session over the weekend. So this is the last race, so any of the sessions previous to this, they're using your times to grid. And that means that somebody with a draft of two or three cars even will get a better lap time than you, and then you don't start in the front row even if you won the race. I won the morning's race. I finished first. This is Saturday because at Thompson in Connecticut, you have a race Friday, Saturday. I won the Saturday morning race, but I still had to start in the third row for this race. Let's get to the racing action. Gerardo had just passed me, and he needs to, like I said, win this race. So he has his work cut out for him. He's still got a few positions to make up. And all I'm thinking right now is I should get back in front of him. Just keep him behind me. Block the crap out of him. But no, I'm not going to be overly aggressive here. If he can win, he can do it. And funny story is he had some engine problems before this race started. And I lent him my spare engine. So right now, that's my spare engine beating me in this race. I guess my spare is pretty damn good. I should put it in. But, oh well, that's the way we do it in Formula B. If he can outdrive me, he can outdrive me, and I know that he can. As long as his car holds together. So, he got stuck a little bit there behind Martin Fosbury. He's not usually racing with us. This is his first time out this year. And if I'm not mistaken, it's his only time out this year. But he's always fast. He can just jump in the car and go. And you're going to see that Gerard's going to actually just send it right up the inside of him. He's going to be super aggressive here. Thought about following him through, but there was no way. And he was a little too aggressive there because he slowed back down. So Mark's going to go right back by him. Pinch him out a little bit there. I think that was fair game racing. And now I'm just gonna stay glued to Gerard's rear end. We don't wanna let him get away too far. I know he's gonna be aggressive. And really the pressure's on him. I could just pull off the racetrack at this point. My finishes this year have been 1, 2, 3 in just about every race. So we have 4 drops out of the 12 races that we do in New England. We drop 4 races and all my drops, my worst finishes are I think 3rd and 4th places, so I would have to finish 2nd or better, 2nd or win this race to improve my points at all. If I don't finish 1st or 2nd, I might as well roll off the racetrack. It's not going to change anything. But we're not going to do that. We're going to finish this race and see what we can do. So, you can see Gerard getting held up there a little bit. Again, Mark isn't has been racing all year. This is his first time in the car, well, towards the end of the weekend, so he's pretty much got the track figured out. But we are a little quicker than him, I think. And we're going to see that in a little bit. Gerard got by him. And now I need to get by him. Gerard made a little bit of a mistake there. His front end washed out a little bit. He's pushing. He's pushing hard. He wants to go to the front. I think he's realizing that that engine does have legs. And it can go. So he's his foot down. Try to close that gap. It's a nice car in the line. Which I think is looks like, yep, it's Jeff Lepowski right there. So you can see the gap in his palm. Fosbury, again, Fosbury not quite as fast as those S's. So I've got a run on him now. Got his draft. I'm thinking I can make this happen. Turn one, he's thinking it too, because he's trying to block me, staying on the right hand side, but he knows that I gotta run off, and this is gonna happen. So, backed out a little early there, go over to the left, so make the corner as wide as I can make it. Lose a minimum amount of time. And you can see on my dash, it's the Micron, the AIM Micron system in there. We're showing green lights, I got four green lights, that means 4/10 faster than our fastest lap in the race so far. So just in a few first few corners there, we're up 4/10. Now 5/10, so we're better than half a second. We're gonna maintain that through these next set of corners. And we're gonna start pushing to see if we can catch that back, because there's quite a gap there. Formula B can sometimes be hard to make up gaps this big, but my car has been handling good all weekend, and I'm confident that I can do it. More than half a second faster than our fastest lap. This is going to be a good one. And I can't let Gerard get away, because I want to fight until the end. I'd love to win this championship, but I think right now, going into this weekend, I knew it was going to be tough, and I'm perfectly happy in second place, to be honest with you. It's been a long year. We've done 10 races this year, including the runoffs. We went out to Virginia twice. We traveled out to Pocono, to Watkins Glen, Lime Rock Park, Connecticut. We've been all over, and I can't wait to see the checkered flag at the end of this one and just put the car away for the winter and take a little bit of time off from racing. Okay with that, because those guys needs to beat them up there and do my job for me, because I'm way back here. So, Chase, Jeff, please pass him. And don't let him win the race. If he finishes anywhere but first, it's over. I'll take it. So again, that lap is a couple of tenths up. Best lap of the session for me. No purple sectors, that's what we want to see. Closing up some more of that gap. I know I have the car, I know I have the engine, I know I can drive it. I'm thinking right now I can still win this race. Probably about halfway through. And I know it's a 20 minute plus a lap race. So there's still time if I can keep putting down laps like that. Definitely slowed down a little bit, maybe due to that lap car. Maybe there was a little bit of slowdown in turn one. They were battling each other. But even though I'm down 4 tenths, I still gained a bunch of them. See, I'm down 5 tenths now. Oh, Sam Ryan goes off a little bit there in the dirt. It's not what we need. We need to keep it on track. Keep pulling me ahead. Sam and Jeff, they're from out of town. They don't normally race with us. but they're very fast, top-of-the-line drivers. I love to be on track with any time I can. This is a track that they're used to, so they're just a hair off the pace here, but normally they would be just flying. I mean, they're flying now, but normally the shoe would be on the other foot, and I'd be trying to keep up with them at a track that they know well. But I have a lot of laps at this track, and I know all the little nuances that there is to know, and the little tiny things that can make you fast. That's the same with Gerard and Chase, who are up front. You can see they're pulling away. So they're actually, they got a heck of a race going on. Gerard is trying to break the draft on Chase by swerving all over the front right away, but it's just not going to happen. So here we go. Jeff gives me the point by. He knows I got to run on him. He knows I caught him from a little ways back. So even though I made a little bit of a mistake there, going into the corner a little tighter than I wanted to after making that pass, but Jeff is also very aware of the championship and what's going on, and now it's down to just me and Gerard, so all I gotta do is get up to those guys. I think I'd have a good shot at it. If I finish second in this race, it would improve my points enough that me and Gerard would tie, and it would come down to the fourth place finishes, honestly. So in the event of a tie, it defaults to the driver who has the most wins. And in our case, we would be tied for wins. So then it would go to second places. We would be tied for second places. Then it would go to third places. And we would be tied for third places. So then it would go to fourth place finishes. And I actually have one more fourth place finish than Gerard does. So I would win by fourth place finishes at that point. And I think that would be an amazing way to end the season, but unfortunately, our lap times are not improving here late in the stages of this race. So I'm a little bit frustrated in the car. I'm battling it a little bit more than I want to be. I don't understand exactly why I'm not getting purple sectors or being able to go flat out. Again, I'm not going to blame it on that wheel, but it probably had something to do with it. Just could have been my frustration with that big gap and some lap traffic that opens the gap up even more. But oh well, that's the way the cookie crumbles. And had a great season. Had a lot of wins this season, a lot of podiums. The car held together great. Always had tons of power. Did 10 races this year, and all on the same engine. No hiccups on that engine at all, and she's still pulling strong, even in this last race. So we're going to take a look at it over the off season, and we might even run it next year, just the way it is, without a crew building it, but we're going to see. Gap is staying the same. Those two got away from us. I know that we only have a couple laps left in this race. It's probably not going to go my way. Taking into account that. that. And looking at the map counter while you're driving, because that's my basically the timer of the race. I don't have a actual timer on there. Here's fellow driver, Andy Shoemaker. He gets out of the way nicely for me. Thank you, Andy. Chase, come on, buddy. Pull it in. Last time through the Sun Hustles. Look at that crowd up there on the hill. All those people watching the big Formula V race. Coming around the last corner. And we're just going to take it easy on the road. Check the flag here. Pull the last tear off. Clean the visor. Give the corner workers a wave, and honestly, I couldn't be happier for Gerard. Congratulations, buddy, and really happy to end the season like this, and Chase did an amazing job this year.